about tonight.
I love it. I love performing.
I think this is the biggest crowd that I feel comfortable because they older.
And they understand more. Because usually we're like in front of like younger crowds and stuff. So I think that they're going to actually understand it, you know, give us the right response that we're looking for.
Ben is the first in a monthly series that is brand new for us and actually leads up to the opening of our exhibit, Race, Are We So Different? That exhibit will open in January, so we are pleased to begin the discussion now and get some thoughts from you and get your feedback.
Who is you? Can anybody relate to that situation? I mean, I know that, you know, we often are in different places and people want to define who you are, whether they define if you're black, whether you're African-American, whatever the case may be. How does it feel when someone has to define who you are?
What I find fascinating is I personally used to choose between who I was. I would just kind of forget my mom existed, and she's about the whitest white woman I've ever met in my life. And I'd say, I'm black, I'm just black, you know, because it was just a lot easier. And then they'd start questioning me about the way I spoke. Well, if you're black, how does white speak like that? So then I started a whole other conversation, and they'd say, you ain't black, you don't speak the right way. So then it was a whole other conversation, and then when my mom showed up, it was all over. So.
We are in a very diverse city, and the reason a lot of people here may not agree is because we don't interact with them. It doesn't mean that our city isn't diverse. It means we're not diverse. We don't interact with different ethnicities or different religions, but you better believe St. Louis is truly a melting pot. We just haven't mixed up yet.
All of us bring so much richness to each other's lives and to St. Louis, and if it gets all mushed up, we're going to lose all the differences that we bring. And I want us to be able to celebrate the differences rather than get all mushed together. Salad or a orchestra is what I think.
You talk about diversity, but it's really beyond diversity. It's inclusion, and that's where you appreciate a person for who they are and what they have to bring and their strength, and you use that to build a strong unity or a strong unit, and you don't try to make a person who they're not, because then you do take their strength.
You look around, and this is truly a diverse audience. I don't think I've ever been in a more, or participated in a more diverse audience, from age, from gender, from race.
The issues of discrimination and prejudice have been a huge part of America's history. Over time, these issues have affected many different people in many different ways. But one thing still remains the same. Whether in the form of a brutal comment or a brutal murder, prejudice and discrimination are destructive forces that harm the world around us.
So, how do we rid ourselves of this evil?
It is not an easy task, but we can make this world a better place if we just try.
Treat everyone